Bella. This is Bella. Bella. She got one big eye. She wants some ham. She wants some pork. She likes more ham.
We are going to show you how to make a Christmas dinner, a holiday dinner, if you will. One important part of that, I think most people agree, is some meat. Here I have a whole pork leg, and I picked it up from the butcher, and I'm actually keeping it right in the bag because we're going to use the bag to brine it. First step is to figure out how much brine you're actually going to need. I'm going to cut a slit in the top of this bag, just like that. Take a pitcher. I'll be working with cold water at this point. All right. Is that looking good or what? Just gonna set this in the sink. We're gonna go with a cup and 3/4 of kosher salt per gallon. We just need enough water to dissolve our salt in. Go in our water. Salt is dissolved. I've got some ice in here to help cool that down. And then I'll take the rest of this ice. I've done it for up to 6 days in the brine. You can do it, you know, 12 hours, I would say a minimum, to have some sort of an effect. Just like that. Boom. Hold it. Mix that around a little bit. Fill this with ice, monitor it, make sure it stays chilled. Brining is a step you don't have to do, but it's gonna make your food taste better.
Hey guys, what's happening?
What's up, Gus? Yeah, we're about to ham it up.
This ham looks pretty lovely. I mean,
yeah, the view's not bad. But we got, check it out, Vinny, or Vin,
I guess,
and Kyler the man. Vinny's like a CrossFit track star, and Kyler's got a CrossFit total of like 1,600 pounds or something like that. Right, Kyler? These guys are going to help me out. I'm just going to kind of guide them through it, and we'll see how the how their domestic skills are. Kitchen. There we have it. So this would be where the, it's kind of like the Achilles for the pig right here, and then the foot would be down just below this. I like this skin. It provides a lot of moisture when it cooks, self-basting, and then also it's fun to eat when it's done, right? Foil, probably need 2 sheets just to make sure that it's covered. And that's just gonna help us for cleaning, right? So when it's all done, we don't have this super crusty pan. Basic ingredients, apple juice, maple syrup, granulated garlic, and chipotle sauce. All I did with this was pureed a can of chipotle peppers with some water, just that I could get that consistency. Like 2 cups, right? Like a pint. Something about like that. Chipotle. Maybe put like half of that container in there. The maple syrup, let's put like 1/4 of that jar. And then the granulated garlic, 2 tablespoons. That looks good. So go ahead and just whisk that up, and then we'll give it a taste. Kyler, how you doing over here?
Perfect.
Just, we're gonna put these across like this, and we'll just set the leg on there. If you want to get the grill fired up, go ahead and do that.
Again, frothy. Too much.
See how it tastes. You want to taste it?
It tastes good. It's hot.
We got a little heat, a little kick at the end. Right. Try to get this stuff as close to the bone as possible. I'll just stick this thing in here. Ooh.
Got it close to the bone.
That one should work, dude. That one looks a little more heavy duty, yeah.
I want to break this one, too.
That's pretty tough skin, dude. I don't know. It's got the ring.
Yeah, that works. That was just cheap. Buy quality stuff, you guys. Right? And they're just nice and easy. Oh! So this one, you'll kind of see stuff will shoot out. It'll either come back out where you are, or it'll come out some other parts. When that happens, you just slow down or pull it out. Boom. So we're kind of good in this area. We'll just hit probably 4 or 5 more areas. How'd that go, man?
Pretty good.
Tyler, you up or what, dude?
What are you trying to
on the gloves, dude. You try the foil in the gloves.
You get nervous.
Foil. Hold on. Boomerang. All the back. Is that good?
I'll do it.
25-pound pig leg carry. Boom. We got our smoke going. Do you guys agree? Smell it. Going for internal temp of like 160 to 165. Sound good? All right, Kyler, thanks, man.
Appreciate it.
Vinny, good job, man. The injector.
10:30.
We're about 2.5 hours in, and here's what we're looking at. Just coming along, getting a little color on the skin. You can see where we made one of the penetrations. We just added some more chips. So we got a lot of smoke going right now, but that'll dwindle, and then we'll just keep feeding that.
Looks good.
Oh, yeah. Just hit that. So somewhere between 160 and 170 is where you want to be. And make sure that your ham is done. All the way deep in the middle, just over 160, 165. All right, that's what we're looking for. So we got our nice crispy skin. I've let this rest for about 15 minutes. We're gonna take it upstairs and slice it up. It's gonna get juicy in here. Doesn't look like a conventional smoked spiral ham at the grocery store. Here's what's going on. We just need to get through the skin. Kind of peel that away. And as I was saying earlier, that's like a little casing that just traps in tons of moisture. Self-bastes. And we can also eat it. Look at that cracking away. Mm-hmm. Not garbage, you guys. I'm just setting it aside. And from there, you can just start carving away. It'll pretty much fall apart. Skin sticking to my teeth, guys. A good sign. So now I pulled this bone away, just kind of peeling some of the meat, and then I'll start carving down this side too. And all you really want to do is just carve around all sides. It should come away, the meat will come away from the bone really easily. This is super moist, it's got a little kick to it. Got it all cut up. This is what's left of the bone. I'm just pulling apart. Crackling. Hear that crackling? That's why it's called crackling. And you don't get this when you buy a ham in the store. I'm gonna make another brine that we pour over this to serve it in. Okay, water. There. Bring it up to a simmer, and I'll add some salt. I'm gonna say 1/4 cup of salt. Over the top of the fork. There it is. Holiday ham.
Heavy or mixed ham. Happy holidays. Bella, come get it.